Well, I don't think we're venturing into the unknown. We're returning to a situation which we've had for many hundreds of years, a self-governing democracy. So what we faced is we started with a common market, we moved to a community, good neighbourliness, trying to agree, and then we moved to a union. And with that union came a decision to have a single European currency. Now, in no area in the world have you ever been able to have a single currency that works without a single country. And this Eurozone has now been in crisis for 6 years, is showing no signs of dealing with its fundamental problems, mm-hmm. which is the capacity to shift money from different parts of a country. In all of our countries, United States, you give money to your poorer regions, West Virginia, coal mining areas, or difficulties in the textile industries. And the central government is able to, if you like, make things more equal and more more citizen, more democratic.
But the UK is not part of the Eurozone. The UK controls its own monetary policy. It controls its borders. Nobody comes into the UK without showing their passports. And if they're not EU citizens, without a visa. So why then is this issue of immigration, of centralized control that the UK doesn't have to abide by, such a big issue for the Leave campaigners?
If you are tied into a single market, and if you are not part of the single currency, you are profoundly affected by it. Mm-hmm. And if there is a collapse of the Eurozone, or a big country like Italy can no longer live within these disciplines, you will find it impacting on your own citizens very considerably. Mm-hmm. So let's stop this belief that we're completely in. We are not. And the second thing you said is we control our borders. We don't. There is an automatic right for all European member states, citizens, to move to each other's countries. Yes, because we're not part of Schengen, you show the passport, but it is very difficult to control. There is no real power of refusal. And if you do refuse, even an individual with a criminal record, it can go back to the European Court of Justice. So we do not have control of our borders. And all of these things are beginning to make many British people very unhappy with the so-called democracy in which they live. And this is a grassroots feeling that things have gone too far.
But why so-called democracy? Is there a single law that has been imposed on the UK that the UK has not wanted to impose on it? I mean, can you point to a single piece of legislation from Brussels that the UK wanted to reject but was imposed on the country?
72 times the British government has called for a vote on what they consider to be a very important major national interest, and 72 times they've been defeated. So that's the record of actually votes that are called by the British government. But of course, a lot of the time, they compromise and the give and take. But, I mean, you know, which other country would be prepared to do this? You're in a trade agreement, NAFTA. That doesn't mean that you, in America, give up your right to control and make your own laws, and similarly for Canada and similarly for Mexico. It's a very unusual arrangement. And underneath it, there is a constant pressure to create a United States of Europe similar to America. It took you many, many decades before you could even agree and have a single currency.
You are ready, Lord Owen, to support the idea of the UK leaving the EU and put this country through 2 years of negotiations to go over every single trade agreement, not just that the UK has with the EU, but that the EU has with the rest of the world. It took a small country like Greenland leaving the EU 2 years to do that, and there are only 55,000 inhabitants in Greenland. Do you think it's doable even?
I do think it's doable. I think it is better not to have to do it, and we would have preferred not to have done it. And we've only come to this conclusion, really, because of the repeated failure of the European Union to grapple with the problems of the Eurozone. The United States has been begging them to make these changes. For the last 6 years, all your Treasury secretaries have been pressing, particularly Germany, but also the Netherlands, to make these changes. They cannot make them. And if you look forward, we're likely to be stuck with this mess for a considerable number of years. Now, we have to ask ourselves, do we want this direction of travel? We were very happy in the European common market. We were reasonably, and I believe I was personally very happy with the European community. Well, it's this big shift towards a single European state, which the British people have never wanted, and now seeing it, don't, in my view, will vote not to stay with it.